Hi, it's me and Noah.
10 million will die.
Superbugs, right?
Should we be worried? I think so.
Hi, I'm Stephanie from Bangkok. I have been cooking for more than 10 years.
Cooking for me is passion. My husband from Canada, his name is Andrew, and my son is Noah. We are foodies. I can't imagine Thai cooking without chicken, because like it's in all like traditional dishes. The most like famous one is called gapao gai. Key ingredients, also of course chicken and also chili, because it's Thai cooking, and Thai basil.
It smells so good right now.
It's very tasty, very healthy, very easy to make. And sometimes I'm very picky in choosing my ingredients.
So one thing I have been worried about is antibiotics in our meat.
So this one has antibiotic-free sticker on it, but this one doesn't have anything.
I read that they did some sample of the chicken in supermarkets and found antibiotic in almost half of them.
Antibiotics left over in the meat actually is just a tip of the iceberg. The big issue is how much it has been used while raising the animals for your meat.
So are those antibiotics used in livestock the same as the antibiotics used in human?
There are a lot that are the same.
So here's my doxycycline, the most common found antibiotic in chicken. And it's also common medicine used in human for infection. Any kind of infection, acne, stomach, bladder infection, even malaria.
And if they use that antibiotics in animals a lot, it can induce the bacteria to resistant to the same antibiotics that we are using nowadays.
Okay, that's scary.
It's so difficult to understand. Like you start, what is AMR? AMR is an acronym. It's short from the word antimicrobial resistance.
Superbugs, right?
Yes.
Eating meat with AMR bacteria contamination can lead into unhealthy consequences.
If we eat meat with the superbugs, there's a chance that superbugs will stay in our body, and that also increases the chance that the superbugs will infect us. In our body, there are a lot of bacteria already, and that's what we call colonize. We have a lot of good friends in our guts, in our lungs, that they are good bacteria. And there are also sometimes we can call foes that can cause the infection.
You're about to find out more about this, and I'm into it.
So today I had a chat with Greenpeace team, and it's quite shocking that they found E. coli bacteria and also AMR bacteria in the meat.
I think that's worrying.
We took the sampling from 4 provinces. Most of the sampling got E. coli, which is a kind of bacteria, and also some of the AMR version of E. coli.
So Greenpeace, I want to know what these bacteria come from.
The bacteria E. coli and the AMR version of E. coli, it can come from many various sources.
The more we use antibiotics, it will go to the environment, it go into the water, it will go to the soil, it comes back to us in nearly every form.
It's true, and it did scary.
So this is the public school, like the one I went to.
ถ้าถามว่ากังวลไหมก็กังวลนะเพราะว่าเราต้องประกอบอาหารให้เด็กทานทุกวันใช่ไหมคะแล้วเด็กเราค่อนข้างเยอะพันกว่าคน
What do you think about school lunch here?
Delicious.
So what are your favorite chicken dishes?
Fried chicken.
Yes, fried chicken.
Yes, I fried chicken also.
ทีนี้โรงเรียนเราเนี่ยเราไม่สามารถที่จะเจาะจงหรือเลือกซื้อลักษณะที่แบบว่าเหมือนกับไม่ได้ใช้ยาปฏิชีวนะหรืออะไรเงี้ยบางทีเราไม่สามารถที่จะก้าวเข้าไปรับรู้ได้ใช่ไหมคะเราก็ใช้วิธีการแก้ปัญหาของเราโดยเวลาประกอบอาหารเนี่ยเราก็จะใช้วิธีการประกอบอาหารให้สุกมากๆคิดว่าอย่างน้อยที่สุดเนี่ยความร้อนของไฟมันก็อาจจะช่วยได้ในบางส่วน
If you cooked meat properly most of the bacteria will dieBut some genes might survive on the cooked meat, and you might take it in, and that small genes might still spread into your body.
Are children more vulnerable for AMR bacteria?
They are more vulnerable, they are smaller, and if they get infected, if it goes to the blood, go to their brain, go to their lung infection, cause pneumonia, they have a higher chance to get bad outcome.
So the world authorities are really worried about AMR bacteria.
If we don't do anything, it is projected that within 2050, 10 million will die because of the AMR.
I just got a goosebump. So now we're heading outside of Bangkok. We're going to see AMR patients.
Doctors need the good antibiotics to save lives. But if you use too much, if you use for yourself without thinking properly, if you use in animals too much, you are inducing the antibiotic resistance.
It's actually a young boy, and we're about to meet him. So the boy's inside, so just put the mask on. Better be safe, okay? So the boy, his name is Natmo, and now he's 9 years old. And when he was 7, he got sick by AMR bacteria, and it almost got him killed. The antibiotic that normally used for this cure cannot help him. Your child might die, you know, and then you cannot help them, help him. It's just like, it's just horrible.
จนสุดท้ายไปเจอคุณหมอรุ่นนี้เนี่ยท่านบอกว่าน้องเป็นเกี่ยวกับเชื้อดื้อยา
The reason why it's very dangerous because then we can suffer or die from something that usually treatable. I heard you have a child, right?
Right.
If you give birth by having cesarean section, if you don't have antibiotics, maybe the day you give birth to your son might be the same day that you pass away as well.
In the future, when you really, really need antibiotics for treatment, it might not work for you anymore.
With Superbugs, they can hand over their resistance to other bacteria so they can fight off modern medicine.
They actually have a structure that they can actually transmit the gene to their friend. To their friend, just like airdrop. They're able to incorporate that segment of gene, even from the dead bacteria, into their own DNA, so that they become resistant.
We are spreading the whole world with antibiotic resistant bacteria. Farms is one of the places that use a lot of antibiotics, and that's not good.
We are heading to a chicken farm 5 hours northeast of Bangkok. We cannot know that this chicken farm is using antibiotics. We have to like clean ourselves with sanitizer in order that they make sure that we're not like give any disease to the chicken and make them sick. It's quite ironic, huh? Chicken contracts some disease, it can pass on to their friends. Now I see, I understand. I'm so sorry now, I'm so overwhelmed by everything. Maybe we just get it done and get it out of here. You ready? Here. It's for you. They give antibiotics to the chicken, like, you know, just to prevent them from getting sick, even though they are not sick. So maybe the right way or the best way to avoid it is to, you know, choose something else. Our hero, tofu. Grapao, but in different version is tofu grapao. So after all I have learned from over the past week, I decided I can live with this. I can eat less meat, AMR bacteria, antibiotics, you know, like we don't really need those things in our life. Maybe we can make a better and safer place for him in the future.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.